even though the rules of 23, let's say for the death penalty, over certain other issues, they're lesser judges, although they have to have the minimum certification, qualification, smicha. Yeah, you have to have smicha. Well, this smicha is not smicha we talk today, ordinary. This is pyramidal smicha, ordained for kosher. There's no concept of what? Just the Torah. This speaks once about it. Well, you have to wait and see. It's a wait and see. No. Doesn't exist. Nobody wants it. There's no incarceration. Why have you seen it? No. The law enforcement is being forced to the law of the court. So let's say the court ruled that he has to be in prison for 25 years. He doesn't want to go to jail. So you the law enforcement will force him into prison. Yeah. We left off page Tezayin, first column, bottom paragraph. Perkei lo nedarim, sholch mi tami. They sent the tami to Eretz Yisrael. He zor b'mnei aniyim. You should be careful regarding the children of the poor. Just that in that long word, not the only. He zor b'mnei aniyim. Shemehem tozi tezit zoro. The children of the poor, Torah will emanate from them. No, so if you learn Shas. Shenemar, and the Gemara quotes a pasuk, Yizal Mayim Idolyo, but Dolyo, to be Dole means to draw water, right? Bidolyo Midalim Shemim, meaning from the most impoverished. Dal is a poor person. And Mayim is always Torah. Easy, you should draw the water from where the water should flow, Midalio from the Dalim. Take Midalim Shemem, take the Torah, Neymatam, the Chachomim, and Yotzimim, Talmid Chachomim. Why, if parents themselves are Talmid Chachomim, why are their children less likely to be Talmid Chachomim? This is Gemara, it's quoting the Gemara. Shalom Yomri Yerushalayim. Because the reason why it's more difficult for a Talmid Chachom's child to be a Talmid Chachom, I'm not saying it can't be. But there's less of a siyata d'shmaya because God doesn't want people to say, you know, it's inheritance. We get it by right. It's right of inheritance. It's not inheritance. Each person's sharing Torah is based on his own, not his own acquisition. Your father could be Moshe Rabbeinu. Unless you invest in time, it's irrelevant who your father was. So to indicate, to emphasize this point, the Torah comes from the people who specifically the parents are not Talmid Chachamim. Should not be said it's an inheritance. Rav Shish Brei Dividi Omer Kadesh Lo Yisgadru Al Atzibur, because otherwise the children of if it's always the families, they corner Torah. They dominate. They become empowered over the Tzibur. They take on a position of, you know, it's like royalty. Different words. They shalom. You have to understand that. Ravashim they shekorin lanchi chomri. Here they refer to people, the children of Talmid Chom. They refer to the children to other people that are like donkeys, like chamorim. Ravino Amar they shemvorch me'atorat chiva. That's the conclusion. Because they don't say the birchas haTorah. Fabiyaru mashomri zorb ne'aniyim b'mkomu b'tziv haTorah b'shamav b'vur. Uma shomar kil kachin Talmid Chom yotzei. What is the meaning? The reason why Talmid Chachamim are less likely to have children Talmid Chachamim, so they should not say it's an inheritance. Torah is not an inheritance to anybody. It's not an inheritance. It's a morosha. So morosha means we have a right, it's our heritage, it's not inheritance. We have a right to partake of it. But it's not yours unless you partake of it. It's not something which is physical. which a son inherits from his father. Ki b'toreh ha'seichel, Torah is something which is knowledge, which has to do with the intellect. The tochens and the horish to Russell know that a person could person has certain genes, a person parents are geniuses. There's a greater likelihood that children be geniuses. That's capability, but it has nothing to do with the actual knowledge, right? It has to do with what knowledge is. What that's one's own personal acquisition, one's initiative that you take to apply yourself. What causes the child to come out? It's a physical phenomenon. I'm not sure what he says over there. He says, he explains over there that an Amoretz has greater relevance to father-child who's a Talmud Chochem, meaning he takes the initiative, than a Talmud Chochem fathering the child. Ki Amoretz roi daf k'sheitzim b'dam Chochem, f'chein yotzim et Talmud Chochem, ma'ash omesh lo yomra, stop. I'm not sure what he writes over there. I mean, what would be smart of it? An Amoretz, a person is devoid of Torah and parent. His child has greater relevance, is a greater likelihood to gravitate to Torah than the father who's a Talmud Chochem. Why? You want to say it's the Siyata Dishmaya is one thing. I'm not sure what he writes over there. I understand that. But he just finished saying something. The whole idea is intellectual. Knowledge is not an inheritance. Your father's a doctor. The son doesn't go to medical school. The son's not a doctor. Yeah, it's not only Torah. It's anything which has to do with, which is intellectual. It's any capability. Personally, unless the person's trained. Father is a tailor. The son never was taught to be a tailor. He's not going to be a tailor. Even the tailor is something which is physical. Right? It's a physical ability. Or a craftsman, carpenter, whatever he is. But you appreciate it. But we'd have to come on to think because once. You don't need anything. It's not a profound concept. It's understood. It's not something which is limited, unique to Torah. It's regard to anything. Right? Father's a physicist. The son's going to be a physicist unless he has the ability or applies himself to study physics. He's not a physicist. It's not something which is specifically Torah. It seems to be something that has relevance to Torah. Torah is not a Yerusha. Medicine is not a Yerusha. It's true regarding anything. And the child himself applies himself. What it means, what? Talmud Chochem, the son can't be a Talmud Chochem. All Rabbi Yehuda Hanasi's children, I mean, they were great. They. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just saying. Children, or most Tanoim, the children were what? Okay. Yeah, but to be the Nasi, you don't have to be a great Talmud Chochem. Nasi is like the king. Okay, to be continued. No, it's not because his children being denied. Yeah, but I'm saying this has nothing to do with Torah, so it's not right. Torah. It seems to me this is something which is unique to Torah. Okay.